MCQ 39 has a little bit of a QA style together with organic chemistry, whereby we take a look at the reactants and products and try to guess reasonably the kind of reaction that's happening. So our advice for questions like this, we take a look at all the functional groups first. First compound, we have an alkene, an alcohol for the second compound, a carboxylic acid for the third compound, and finally an ester functional group for the last compound. So again, writing up, I have an alkene, followed by an alcohol, followed by a carboxylic acid, as well as three, I have an ester. So if you want to go a little bit more, you can give the exact name. A 2-carbon alkene will be an ethene, a 2-carbon alcohol will be an ethanol, a 2-carbon acid will be an ethanoic acid. And if you take a look here, doing a little bit of the split, the carboxylic acid itself donated 2-carbon, the alcohol itself donated 2-carbon. So this is known as an ethyl ethanoate. Where the front part of the ester, the prefix comes from the alcohol, and the second part of it comes from the carboxylic acid. So from alkene to alcohol, we'll be looking for a hydration event. So hydration is the same as an addition reaction. In MCQ 38, the condition has been given. I'll just write it out. Conditions here, we'll be looking at 365, 300 degrees Celsius, 65 ATM, and phosphate 5 acid as a catalyst. Reagent, we'll be looking at using steam. So addition, reaction, for this case for reaction 1, anchors down A and D. So from my alcohol towards my carboxylic acid, the reaction here is going to be an oxidation process. The conditions here will include using potassium manganate or using potassium dichromate as your oxidizing agent. We're going to have excess concentrated sulfuric acid that is acting the role of a drying agent. And the reagent here, we're going to be looking at using oxygen gas. Alright, so again, just writing out KMnO4, potassium dichromate. Dichromate is acting as an oxidizing agent to help to oxidize your alcohol to carboxylic acid. And the corn sulfuric acid here is to acting as a drying agent, because the end of this reaction does actually produce water that could contaminate the carboxylic acid that you will want to remove. And for reaction 3, we're looking for esterification. So some schools does teach esterification as a condensation reaction. They're both fine. So the conditions over here will be looking at us using heat or warming and a few drops of concentrated sulfuric acid. Now in the class itself, it was mentioned several times that the volume of sulfuric acid used have to be really, really particular. Excess for oxidation, but for esterification, we're using a few drops. Recently has been mentioned that if we use too much acid in making of our esters, the acid will actually destroy the esters at the end, and this will cause the yield of your ester to drop. So the reactant over here is going to be carboxylic acid together with alcohol. So with all reaction 2 and 3 actually being given to us, it's actually quite simple. 2 will be going for oxidation and 3 will be going for esterification. So the answer for 39 is 8.